Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. Today we would like to talk about this cross pendant. There are many different ways to make it, but especially I would like to talk about how to get the surface nice, smooth, and puffy. I will show you a couple other ways and talk about the pros and cons on making those pendants. Are you ready? Let's get started. The cross I'm going to use today is about 3x4. There are many different type of the cross, especially if it's really religion specific. You may want to find online for the specific proportion. But what I like to do here is about 3x4, and we use the rectangular tool to create two rectangular, and all we need two rectangle, and all we need to do is trim the curve in between, and let's move this one back to the center. So let's use the move tool and move it back to the zero point. All right, so the first way to make it really simple, you can make it into a solid by just pick up the curve you have, go into the solid, and then you can extrude a planar curve. Okay, so once you have it, you can have any thickness that you want it, and all you need to do is giving a little bit radius. So let's say we want to have a radius 1, and you can have something like this. So that's the first one, all right, really simple one, but it looks really stiff, all right. And if we set a stone on it, it doesn't look good. We want to have something a little bit puffy. So maybe I'm thinking the way to make it puffy, I can create an arc from the midpoint here. Let's make sure the midpoint is on. Midpoint here, midpoint here. And we want to go, let's say, for whatever height that you like. So let's say somewhere there. And another one, we want to go here to here and going up there. All right, so something like this, and then you can adjust it if you want it. Let's say we want it to go this curve, more puffy on that way, and it's more, let me hide this one, it's more taper in this way. So I'm gonna move those two going here or something like that. You can create whatever you like here. But the only problem that I'm seeing here is when I creating a surface with those two curves. So for example, the curve that I have, I'm going to surface extrude this straight, and I want to make sure both sides equal, yes. And then we want to snapping into here. The same thing we're going to do with this one, snapping into there. Overall, it doesn't look like much of a problem. We can close this really quick, but I'm going to enlarge the perspective. Then you can see something like this. The edge, they doesn't respond with the other one. So that you have is a gap here and there. All right, so it doesn't look too good for what we have, but I just want to make it and put it on the side as the comparison. So let me complete this cross. What we can do is I can make another curve here, and make sure I join those two curves and join those two curves. All right, so again, we are going to the curve, solid tool, extruded planar curve, straight, make sure both are equal, yes. And this one, we can have it this. All right, so you can see if that's your design, it's actually perfect. You know, you want to have a little bit gap there. So all we need to do is balling unit those two. Then you have another type of a cross. And again, this is not what I am looking for. I'm just put it there as a comparison for you. So we have cross one and we have cross two here for the comparison. What I like to do is to make something really nice and puffy. It's a continuous surface like the first one, but it has the bump on the top, and then it is a continuous surface, so it's not breaking here. Okay, all right, so the way I'm going to do, I need to make a puffy surface first. All right, so let's go to the top view. Let me hide those two. All right, so what I like to do on the top view, I'm going to use the rectangle tool and then this corny corner. So right click on your mouse. This is the first corner. We're going to snapping into here. The second corner is here. And we want to make something a little bit rounded, so look nicer. Maybe turn off my grid snap. So somewhere about this. Okay, so that's first. The second, we need to find out where's the center of the rectangular. You can see there's a point right there, but if you want to be exact, we can go ahead to use the analyze tool, and there's a mesh property, and you can find the area centroid here. So we click on this curve, and really quickly you see that dot over there. Okay, so we're gonna move everybody to the center. It's just easier for me to model if I can have the things aligned to the zero point. All right, so I'm gonna temporary to hide this one so it's not bother us. And I may need to have it a little bit bigger, look like this, because our cross need to be inside of the shape because we need to cut it off later. All right, so I'm gonna hide it, the cross first, and put this into other layer and hide it. All right, so now what we need to do is we need to decide how high we wanted to have. So let's say I wanna have roughly about 8 millimeter there. Okay, I'm gonna put a little tag in my front view. You can see that there's a little tag here, and another tag is somewhere here, right at the end point. So for those two, I'm going to use the blend tool here, and we want to blend from this one to that one. Okay, so you get this one right there. Now once we got that, we want to use the command to create a surface. It's under the surface and it's called rail revolve. So what we do is we pick up this as our profile. This is a rail, and we want to go from here to here. So that's how we creating this surface. Okay. Now with this surface, what we need to do is bring back our cross, which is I just hide it, so let's show up the object, and let's take a look on the top view. So now we have this cross. All we need to do is use that cross to trim the extra off. All right, so now you see is this is really nice smooth surface right there. Okay, and you can create a thickness if you want to, or you can like the distance that I have here, I can also creating things in between. And the very easy way is you actually going to extrude it that curve straight. And we don't need both sides, we just need the one going one side, and then we want to make sure it's higher than that surface. Okay, then we want to use this surface to trim off the surface right there. So now we have a thickness there. All you need to do is make sure that you join them, and then you can use the cap command to cap it since the bottom is flat. Alright, so this will be the cross that we have as a basic. After that, we can set the stone on the top of it, but we may also alter this a little bit more. Sometimes for men's jewelry, you want to doing some chamfer edges because that make it look muscular. So let's say we want to set it as a dimension. Let me put it 1.5. And we want to choose all of them. So now we can have a completely different look of the cross. And once you have done, you can go ahead to do the stone setting on the top. The stone setting part, as for the B setting, you can see my other video showing here, and I will put the link below the description so you know how to do the stone setting for the top. And then you can have something look like this. I hope you enjoy the video. Please like and share, and very importantly, comments on my video. Let me know how you like it. If you have any suggestion or any other things you like to learn, I will try to make a video for you. Thank you for watching. See you next Monday.